Now, I know that some of you are really nervous about assessment three. Why? Because it's a presentation. Everybody gets nervous about presentations, even those who like them. But presentation is actually one of the most rewarding components of this subject, because this is your opportunity to share your ideas with the community. Now, last year, we had a number of these presentations, obviously, and those ideas, many of them have actually been taken up by the community. Okay, so the work that you're doing here actually has influence on what happens in the community, because our community representatives, sometimes they go, oh my goodness, I love that idea, let's take it, you know, let's run with it and see if we can make it work. So this is a real opportunity to make a difference in a community and to be sharing your ideas and your skill sets with the community. So this is a fantastic chance to do that. Now, the primary thing to remember, even though this is an assessment task, this is a presentation. Okay, you're communicating with not just us, but with community members, your ideas. And so you need to give us a really clear picture of what you're proposing. Now, the recommendation that I make is that you tell a really simple story first that captures the idea, and then you start to develop the complexity of it. But remember that what you need to do is create a clear picture of what this project idea of yours will look like. Now, in this presentation, you can use a range of different medium. We expect you to. So you might come up with a poster to demonstrate how this event might be advertised. You might come up with a short video or an interview. You might present just to, within the meeting like this live. We expect to have some live conversation, obviously. But we're expecting you for you to use a number of different tools to demonstrate and to get us and the community excited about your idea. Okay, so make sure you provide a really clear picture of what you're proposing. Now, part of what you're doing in doing a community presentation or this presentation is not just getting us excited, but it's about proving to us or providing an argument for why you think or how you think your idea, your group's idea, will actually help to achieve the community objectives. So if the community objectives are related to, improving communication between young people, then we want you to provide a really solid argument as to why this idea of a basket weaving club might lead to an improvement in communication. Okay, don't just tell us that you're going to do this and that it will lead to communication improvements. Tell us why that might be the case and draw on a range of evidence to do that. So obviously you've got the modules that you'll be drawing on, so you can draw on them, but also draw on other community projects and other research. You know, have a look at the research and really prove to me that this idea is a really solid one. Perhaps someone else has done it and it's seen that benefit, or perhaps we've got some research that says when you get people to do this, you will achieve this. So really provide a solid justification. Being excited is not enough, okay? So you can get me excited about an idea, that's not enough. You need to convince me that this is not just a cool idea, but that this is an idea that is going to lead to the types of outcomes that the community are asking for. Really, really, really important. It also demonstrates your depth of engagement with all of these ideas. Which is important. Now, the next thing is that it should be a bespoke idea that sits beautifully within the community, okay? Every single rural community that you're working with is inherently different. And part of this process was about understanding the community. And we fully expect that there be a number of connections between the way in which you've designed this and the nature of the community. Okay, so if you're talking about running an event, you need to have a look at the characteristics of the community and ask community members in class where that event should sit. You need to look at the different clubs that are available. Who would you get involved? So we want to see that you've really started to grapple with the nature of the community, this unique community, so that when the community representative watches your presentation, they go, oh my goodness, you're right. You know, we could get on the local footy club and the school and the historical society, and we could actually get them to work together, and that these organizations all exist. So your idea needs to be homed within the community that you're working for. This isn't just an idea that you're going to plonk in any community, okay? This is specific for this community. And most of all, we want you to be creative, but be creative with a purpose. So you're going to use really good presentation style. You should have practiced your presentation in front of one another. You'll craft things that create a clear picture. You might create a poster or you might create a diorama. I don't really care. You can present in any way that you like, but it has a purpose. So I want to walk away from these presentations remembering exactly what's going on, exactly what your proposal is, and having a really, really clear picture of the idea and the reason that it will have impact and the impact that it will have. Okay, so really, really clear presentation, creative presentation, not just bells and whistles for the sake of bells and whistles, but a presentation that's designed to be sticky, that's designed to kind of get into my head and not disappear. We want these ideas that you're developing to actually be implemented. And if you do this really well, the chances of them being implemented are much, much higher. And that, at the end of the day, is what we're aiming for. I am really looking forward to watching these presentations. They're always, I love them. I just really enjoy them. Look, be sure to ask lots of questions on the way through. That's the way that you learn and that's the way that you develop a really good presentation. So we'll see you in a couple of weeks when we get to see these presentations. Thank you. Bye.